You wake up covered in orange paint. There's confetti everywhere and you smell of smoke. What the heck happened?
That's Tuesday.
Now, can anybody special spot whose face that is in the picture? We've photoshopped...
Cariad.
It's Cariad's face.
I did not recognise your own face.
Yeah, I mean, no, Sarah, to be honest, as a man sexily posing with spots all over his body and orange haze, I wasn't instantly sure it was me.
Sandy, tell me, what is it?
They're all...
more clothes off, but I'm not going to because I like the picture.
Those are all methods of dealing with offenders. So what? Anybody waking up with those has probably committed a crime, is the truth of it. Take the orange paintballs, therefore shop staff in Japan, to throw at offenders. They're the size of a tennis ball and they are known as Bohan Yukaraburu, anti-crime colour balls. And the idea of somebody's committing a crime, you throw it at them and then they are marked. Wait,
so
and easier to
you
track.
Have to be good at throwing.
Well, yeah. This is the main problem
yeah,
with them.
You
okay.
Might hit the wrong person.
Yeah, good.
So they are widely distributed and under moments of stress, staff either tend to forget them. Staff tend to forget they've got them.
No reflexes at all.
Carry out reflexes just to go back into the position.
So people forget they've got them, or they freeze, or they see that the robber is armed and think that paintball thing not going to go so well. They have signs in the shops, they've got the orange paintballs, and that does seem to put some people off from robbing those shops.
That's what they do in Poundland. They have a picture of a policeman in the window, because if they put a picture of a policeman in the window, people shoplift less.
Do they?
Yeah.
So they could put a picture of the balls in the window. That's all they need.
Do you feel like you should say something, though, when you throw it? So you should be like, no.
You should be like, yeah,
bad.
Stop.
Stop. No. Stop it.
Yeah.
Bad.
I quite like that with a robber. Stop it.
Stop it.
I was on a train once and there were some boys who'd had sherry too many and they were being very vulgar and loud and frightening some people over on the other side. And I suddenly stood up and I went, that will do. Smoke machines used in some stores in the UK and they set them off and it obscures the view of any stuff in the shop whatsoever.
And makes it like an 80s music video. Yeah. So we're really mad that you're robbing us, but...
Yeah. And confetti is another safety mechanism. When you fire a taser gun, apparently, it also releases a tiny amount of confetti.
Oh, how lovely!
Oh, you know. I just go, ow! Oh, nice! If you look in the middle picture, you can just see little bits, tiny colour bits of confetti.
Has somebody literally thought, oh, I mean, it's so sad, let's jazz it up. And then they get tasers.
It's supposed to deter people using tasers to commit crimes. In order to get a taser, you have to register it with the company, and then you get a specific number, and that number's on the confetti to make sure that, you know, bad people don't use them.
You know what they could have done instead? When I got married, people threw confetti, which was lovely, because it's like pretendy flowers. But some people threw rice, and I don't know if you know this, but rice really hurts. It's like being pelted with grit.
Thank you for watching. Do remember to subscribe to the QI channel and click here to watch more videos. Please, come on, pick something.